2022-15. And we're here today to prepare basically for the upcoming hearing. The hearing panel members are Dr. Mary Jo Gergio, panel chair, Dr. Emily Starby, and Mr. Sheldon Williams. And special prosecutor, Mr. Ruiz, will be handling the executive director. I'm going to run through the items specified in the rule. First, I did hear you guys discussing potential dates for the hearing. Was it 8, 10, and 11 you were all available?
Madam Solicitor, if those work for the board, those are the dates that Mr. Campbell and I have identified as working for our clients.
And your officers available?
Officers available. Is the complainant available?
Yes.
And what's those dates again?
Monday, the 8th, or Wednesday, the 10th, Thursday, the 11th of August.
August. I checked my calendar as we were sitting here, and all those dates are available for me. 8, 10, 11. None of those dates work for you? 8 and 10 are good. Okay, oh, Mr. Williams, you have that whole week. How about, let's look at some other dates in August then.
Regrettably, I'm unavailable the week of the 15th due to a previously scheduled family vacation. But I'm available the week of the 22nd, if that works for Mr. Campbell.
Yes, I'm on family vacation, but I will be here on, so we're in that September.
September.
The weekend of that year.
So that's bad for you, Mr. Campbell?
Yeah.
So do we look at the week of the 29th?
August. The red dogs coming up. Mr. Red Dog.
Yes, I'll just be coming back.
Okay, so we're looking at the week of the 5th of September?
Yeah, I'd be available starting September 1st, which is a Thursday.
September 1st works on our.
Works for me, is it working for you? And does it work for the complainant as well?
Yes, it does. September 1st?
Yeah, for us. September 1st.
Bryan, should we set this for 6:00 PM, like your usual hearings, or is there a preferred time?
6 o'clock is fine.
City County Building. For some reason, the city county building is unavailable, council chambers will find other places.
Whatever.
So for purposes of the hearing, are there any particular issues that the parties are able to simplify or clarify going forward into the hearing?
Madam Solicitor, I think the issues are relatively narrow. I do not think that there's going to be many complications related to it. I think we would anticipate two witnesses at most, or three. So I don't anticipate any needs for any preparation that we need to involve for.
And Mr. Campbell?
Between now and that day, I'm going to have to check on the availability of certain witnesses, and I have to be something.
Okay.
But I do agree this is a very simple issue. I don't think it's a complex issue.
Are there any issues of law that we'll have to deal with ahead of time?
Well, I don't know if you have to deal with it ahead of time. The question from our point of view is that it's our contention that on the basis of the information received, the officer had probable cause to make an arrest. I think the complainant is saying, well, he didn't talk to me. See, we take a view that initially he's a suspect on the basis of information received, and probably shouldn't be talking to the officer. Yes, it's Miranda, the officer, he could waive it, but he ended up I think the attorney will tell them, don't see if you have those.
I agree, though, I don't think that's an issue that has to be addressed before the hearing, it's basically what we're focusing on at the hearing.
Right, well, what is the duty of an officer, because this comes up in a lot of federal court cases, where people say their civil rights are violated, but the courts basically say, if the officer has probable cause to make an arrest, he has no duty to do an investigation for the person to be arrested. In other words, they have no duty to check in and out of the business, and things like that, they just need probable cause.
Right.
And here they had two independents.
I do anticipate, those additional, witnesses being called for to testify.
That's what I'm gonna say, if that's possible, okay?
Is there any?
We, on the question of probable cause, the fact that there was a finding of guilt is personally an issue, that's no longer another issue. In other words, to say now there would be probable cause to arrest would be violating collateral stuff, raised to the judge.
All right, if you're gonna proceed in an argument that the panel's stopped from hearing or adjudicating, I'll need you to submit that in writing at some point prior.
Right.
But.
I'll submit a pre-hearing.
Sure.
Madam Solicitor, in addition, I think that Mr. Campbell brought up some issues regarding subpoena witnesses. My assessment would be is that I imagine we could avoid prejudice to lay people, we can probably stipulate to a great deal of the testimony that they would be offered. So I think that there's certainly the potential for Mr. Campbell and the investigator to reach an accord on some issues prior to the hearing. And again, the issues are not particularly complicated, and I think that a large degree of the reason why this matter is before the board is because we were unable to obtain an interview with the responding officer, and based upon the investigator's inability to balance the scales without one side or the other, this matter being before the board. So I think factually there might be issues which are which might be relevant to Mr. Campbell's case, but we could probably avoid testimony if Mr. Campbell wants to go in that direction. So certainly we can talk about that prior to the hearing as well.
Right, whatever you can work out in terms of stipulations, we're certainly not going to reject fact stipulations if you can work them out.
I might attempt to see if I can get after
that. That would be fine as well. Are there any other matters that we're going to need to address to prepare for the hearing? Is that everything?
No, thank you.
There were a couple things for you to just have in this record.
Yes.
With regard to public notice, the notice of this pre-hearing conference was published in the Post-Gazette, the Tribune Review, the City Paper, and the Pittsburgh Courier on June 8, 2016. The subpoenas were delivered for the officer received by desk officer on June the 9th, and the complainant, Mr. Tarr, picked up his subpoena from our office on June the 14th. Just wanted to ensure that we comply with the required notice.
Is there anything further to be addressed? That concludes our pre-hearing conference on this matter.
Thank you.